209er to ground control. We're loaded and ready to taxi.
209er, taxi to runway 19er. Flight 209er, you are cleared for takeoff.
Roger.
Huh?
LA departure frequency 123.9er.
Roger.
Huh?
Request vector, over.
What?
Flight 209er, clear for vector 324.
We have clearance, Clarence.
Roger, roger. What's our vector, Victor?
Howard radio clearance, over.
That's Clarence, over.
Over.
Roger.
Huh?
Roger, over.
What?
When you're in the pattern or you're in, you know, lots of repetitive closed traffic circuits, what are some kind of clearances that are typically confused? What do you see pilots in general confusing the most or getting wrong the most with some of the clearances I may hear while I'm flying by myself?
There's two major ones that we see a lot. The first one is right or left traffic. A lot of times we get aircraft that will give right traffic. Let's say they've been in a pattern for a while flying touch and goes on the north runway and we need them to turn right for right traffic for this pass. You know, a lot of times they'll turn left because they're just so used to be making that left pattern. So we get the right and the left mixed up quite a bit. And then we get the straight outs. For example, if we give an aircraft, if he's going to extend upwind, some people will say extend upwind. Some people will say fly straight out. I'll call you a crosswind. If there's aircraft coming inbound from the north or there's other aircraft in the pattern, a lot of times we have aircraft that cut other aircraft off. And so that sometimes becomes a problem. But, you know, we try to keep it, our phraseology pretty general, I think. As far as common, like common errors, I think a lot of times the runway assignment gets mixed up, even though I think they're on the right runway. Sometimes we'll say runway 4 left clear to land, and they'll read back runway 4 right clear to land. No, verify runway 4 left, and yes, okay, 4 left. A lot of it is hear back, read back stuff. One other thing, yeah, is following traffic or traffic to follow, I think is kind of an issue as well. And that kind of ties into the you know, maybe getting confused who they're supposed to be following. Maybe they don't know, for example, what a Cessna is, you know. So if we say follow the Cessna heading to your left, they might not know what the Cessna is, you know, or a Malibu, or you know what I'm saying? So that could be something that possibly we can come to some agreement to work on, where we could say, hey, follow the red aircraft, high wing, whatever, you know. There's ways we can fix that.
But on that point, one of the things that I always notice is, if I'm told to follow traffic and I'm having trouble seeing the traffic, a lot of the times it's just I see somebody. I'm not quite sure if that's what it is. One of the things I'll do in that situation, and I want you students to know that this is a good thing to do, call the tower and ask them, hey, I see a guy at 2 o'clock out there, wherever, right? A little bit high, a little bit low. I see this guy. Is that the guy I'm supposed to be following? Yes or no? Absolutely. Yes, it is. Ah, perfect. Bingo. Absolutely. Okay, I'm going to make sure I go behind him. Or no. And now it's like, oh crap. I've been looking in the wrong. Okay, where is it now? So if you're not sure, you see something, ask.
And to follow up on that, don't ever turn crosswind if you're not sure either.
Yes.
If you're not 100% sure you have the correct aircraft to follow, just continue flying straight out and ask us, or we'll update you on the traffic as you're passing them. Or we'll work it out. But the worst possible thing you could do, don't turn crosswind, and also don't make a 360, because that's just as bad. And that happens occasionally, where the pilot will take it upon themselves to make a 360, and that never turns out good.
If I'm a student on a solo and I feel like I'm getting into a jam with, I'm supposed to be following somebody, I can't see them, and now I'm starting to feel stressed because I'm supposed to be turning, maybe there's a couple planes that are somewhat closer than I'm used to being together, would it be acceptable to call the tower and ask you to call my next turn?
Absolutely. And we would encourage them to do that. Again, anything to keep somebody from turning on their own, we'll call your crosswind, we'll call your base, we'll call your turn, whatever you need. We don't have a problem doing that at all.
And for you students, I use that not frequently, but I have used that several times in the past, where I've said, I got like 3 people over here. I got one behind me. Maybe, you know, the pattern is full. I got a guy behind me and I'm supposed to be following. I can't figure out where they're at, but I don't want to mess the guy. I don't want to get into a situation where now there's a guy behind me and we get too close and da, da, da. So that's where, yeah, I encourage that. Chris encourages that, right? Call him up. Hey, I don't see the guy. Can you just call my base? Can you call my crosswind? Yep. And you know what? A lot of the times, not every time, so don't assume this, but a lot of the times it'll happen either right away or really quickly after you ask that, it'll be okay. Now your next base turn is clear. So don't worry that you're going to be forgotten about or you're going to go out for 5 miles. No, it's going to be pretty soon after you make that call that you're going to be allowed to make that next turn.